Today, we are releasing our newest flagship model, GPT 4.0.
Gemini 2.0 enables new kinds of multimodal AI agents.
We're going to try something that, as far as we know, no tech company has done before.
Launch of Amazon Nova.
We are introducing more than 50 plus new products.
Our most capable. We introduced Gemini 1.5 Pro.
Think, plan, remember, and take action.
So O1 is the smartest model in the world now.
Today, we have some exciting new progress to share about the future of AI systems that we're calling Project Astra.
This is a launch we've been excited for a long time. We're going to launch tomorrow, our video product. So we'll care a little bit about what this smart product looks like.
For frontier intelligence.
As someone who has been in the field of AI for past 8 years, a question I get asked a lot is, how can I learn AI and get started from scratch? After going through countless number of open courses, podcasts, newsletters, research papers, and ML projects, I can confidently say that the problem isn't that you are behind, but rather there's so much noise out there. It's confusing, and nobody has shown you a clear, actionable roadmap on how you can navigate through all of this and learn AI. Well, that's exactly what we are diving into in this video today. I'm going to share with you a roadmap on not just learning the technical skills, but also for navigating the evolving landscape of AI in 2025. This isn't just theory. It's based on my experience as an applied scientist at Amazon, as well as my personal journey of learning about this fascinating field. All the resources and more that I'm going to talk about in this video today will also be available in my How to Learn ML in 2025 guide PDF, which can be downloaded for free using the link in the description below. The AI landscape has changed dramatically in 2025. We are not just talking about traditional machine learning models, but large language models, generative AI, and multimodal models are reshaping the industry. So if you're serious about AI in 2025, here's my approach. First off, it's foundational skills, but in a smarter way. And yes, Python is still the king. Python remains crucial, but it is important to not get bogged down in every detail, but rather focus on the essentials. Data structures like lists and dictionaries, control flows like loops and conditionals, functions, and object-oriented programming are crucial. Don't try to learn everything at once, just the core concepts that you will be using most often. And then as you go along the learning path, you can just use tools like ChatGPT to help you in coding. Prioritize the essential libraries first. Tools like Jupyter Notebook for interactive Python programming, along with libraries like NumPy for numerical computing, Pandas for data manipulation, and Matplotlib or Seaborn for visualization. These will be your bread and butter. They will make your life so much easier. So make sure to practice it. To learn Python, honestly, there is no better way than to search Python tutorial on YouTube or Google and get started. But remember to actively code while you're going through the tutorials, as it helps strengthen your concepts. Git and version control are also non-negotiable. It is essential for collaboration in open source community, as well as managing your ML projects that you can showcase in your portfolio. You don't have to learn Git in depth, but try to learn the basic commands that can be handy every day. There are also interactive tools such as GitHub Desktop, which you can use as a good starting point instead of learning the command line interface. Knowing Git makes you a much more valuable asset in top companies. Application Programming Interface, or APIs, are the gateway to the AI world. Often companies like OpenAI, Anthropic, and others release their state-of-the-art models using an API, which can be leveraged by the developers to create their own applications on top of their models. Hence, mastering API is key. Understand how to make requests, handle responses, and integrate AI models into your applications. If you're finding this video helpful so far, make sure to hit that like button. It really helps the video to reach more people who are trying to learn AI. And if you're new here, consider subscribing for more such videos on AI and technology. The second step is to learn math for AI. And the objective is to focus on intuition. Most of the machine learning libraries abstract out the underlying math. So you might ask, why learn it? Which is true from a practical standpoint. But learning some of the core concepts of math, which are an integral part of machine learning, will help you understand how these machine learning models learn and the foundations of how they are actually working. Understanding ML from a math perspective also helps you get clarity that there is no magic behind this, but rather mathematical operations which are getting to learn from large amounts of data. Understanding linear algebra in topics such as vectors, matrices, and their operations, calculus basics such as derivatives and gradients are important for ML optimization, and probability and statistics like probability distribution, conditional probability, and hypothesis testing are important topics. There are plenty of resources to help you learn math, such as 3 Blue 1 Brown on YouTube for visualizing math concepts, Khan Academy, and more. Note that it is important not to get stuck in the math rabbit hole. Focus on the application of these concepts and you will learn the rest along the way. Now comes the interesting part, learning AI the 2025 way. I am assuming for learning Python and maths, you should have spent about a couple of weeks to a month. And since now we have a good understanding of programming and mathematics, we can dive into learning the machine learning concepts. Taking these courses can be time consuming, but they will teach you the core foundation of ML and hence are most crucial. While deep learning and LLMs are the focus of the modern machine learning era, understanding the traditional machine learning algorithms like linear and logistic regression, decision trees, and clustering algorithms provides a valuable context. You can learn these through Andrew Ng's machine learning specialization, which has three courses and teaches you the math as well as the practical applications of these ML algorithms. This course will guide you through the classical ML concepts, which are regularly asked in the ML interviews as well, and is absolutely free. During this course, you will also learn to code in ML frameworks like scikit-learn and TensorFlow. Personally, my favorite is PyTorch, but once you learn one framework, you can easily adapt it to other frameworks as well. After this, I would recommend to continue learning with deep learning specialization, which not only teaches you about neural network, convolutional neural networks, language models like recurrent neural networks, but also about practical knowledge of how to structure your ML projects, hyperparameter tuning, and more. Next, you would want to get started with transformers, the game changers in the modern era of large language models. I would highly encourage you to take the generative AI with large language models course on Coursera by AWS. This course will teach you about large language models and prompt engineering techniques to get the most out of LLMs. How can you train and fine-tune LLMs, as well as instruction fine-tuning techniques like reinforcement learning with human feedback. These are the core technologies behind large language models like ChatGPT, Claude, and more. Then you can take a look at Stanford's CS25 Transformers United playlist on YouTube, where they teach about self-attention, mixture of experts, and more, and these lectures are given by industry experts. In parallel to which, you can do short courses by deeplearning.ai on topics like LangChain, LLM agents, retrieval augmented generation, diffusion models for image creation, and more. This is a rapidly growing area with huge potential. These are critical skills in 2025. And don't worry if you don't know about these topics as of now. At the end of these courses, you will know all of these in depth. Fourth is building real-world projects. While learning from courses is important, it is also crucial to have hands-on experience, which is why you should be doing projects. The portfolio of projects is everything. This lets you showcase what you have learned on the way of your ML journey, as well as give visibility to your recruiters of your capabilities. Start small. Begin with small projects to solidify your understanding, such as sentiment analysis, image classification, or creating a simple chatbot. Even the courses that I mentioned previously have capstone projects, which solve real-world problems using toy datasets. So don't skip implementing those and put them in your portfolio. You can also try solving Kaggle competition problems, which also have prize money. But more importantly is the learnings that you get out of it, as well as the community of other competitors who are providing solutions to those problems. Replicate and innovate. Don't be afraid to re-implement existing research papers. More often than not, the ideas presented in these research papers are very simple to implement, and the authors often also provide the GitHub repositories to their code. This is an excellent way to learn and build your portfolio, and then you can try experimenting with your own twist into these code repositories. Remember to document everything. Create GitHub repositories, write blog posts, or create videos about your projects. This is crucial for showcasing your work. Fifth is staying up to date. As a researcher in an evolving field like artificial intelligence, it is utmost important to keep yourself up to date to latest trends that are happening in the industry. I would recommend you to follow key researchers and organizations on platforms like Twitter and X. A few I would recommend following, though not a complete list, is Andre Karpathy, Jim Fan, Yann LeCun, Demis Hassabis, and Andrew Ng. Sign up to AI newsletters like The Badge from Deep Learning or The Small AI Newsletter. These give you a daily or a weekly tidbits on the latest trends that are happening in artificial intelligence and machine learning, as well as the research papers that are trending. Explore research papers strategically. Don't try to read every paper. Focus on papers relevant to your interest and use tools like connected papers to explore related work. I have a 5-step process on how to choose and read research papers effectively, which helps me in understanding about any research topic fast and in depth. If you would like to know my 5-step process, make sure to comment research paper in the comments down below and subscribe so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. As a researcher, embrace the continuous learning. AI is a rapidly evolving field. Be prepared to learn new concepts and technologies throughout your career. This roadmap is a starting point, and all the resources that I have talked about in this video and more details are present in my How to Learn ML in 2025 guide PDF, which can be downloaded for free using the link in the description below. Your journey will be unique. The key is to be curious, persistent, and adaptable. Don't be afraid to experiment, make mistakes, and learn from those. The AI world of 2025 is full of endless possibilities for those who are willing to learn and explore. I hope this video has given you a strong foundation roadmap of learning AI in 2025. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe for more content on AI and technology. Let me know in the comments below what concepts are you most eager to learn. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.